radio station.
Something's in the air tonight. The sky's alive with the burning light. You can mark my words, something's about to break.
All right, 8 o'clock hour, we are live and in studio on July 5th. The Power Trip Morning Show. Happy to have Mike Musman in. Hi, Mr. Mike Musman.
What's going on, buddy?
Hey, your friends down at Lakefront, did they find somebody to fill in for Mr. Toby Keith?
Yes, actually, and what a get. Alabama is going to be playing.
Oh, no kidding?
Yeah.
Oh,
yeah.
Good for them,
Randy,
man.
Owen and the boys are going to be playing. That's going to be really sweet.
They had an open day. That's incredible.
Well, because they technically retired.
Oh, okay.
But they only do so many shows throughout a year, and normally they're like charity ones.
Oh, man.
But they're buddies with Toby Keith.
Oh, okay, got it.
And
okay.
He's got stomach cancer.
Yeah, poor guy.
And, yeah.
Yeah, well, that's good news.
It's going to be awesome. It's going to be a lot of fun. Lakefront Music Festival is just an absolute blast.
And that's coming up pretty quick, isn't it?
That's this weekend.
Yeah, that's what I thought.
Yeah.
Sammy Hagar? Are you kidding me?
Yeah, that's Friday night. Yeah, the Rock Night is Friday night, and then Saturday night. It's country night.
Yeah.
Yeah, it's going to be so much fun.
Fantastic. I love that festival. It's always been some of the best times of my life, man.
Yeah, you played that how
a
many
bunch
times?
Of times.
Yeah.
I don't know. It's always great.
I think, weren't you like maybe first 3 years of when they actually decided to change it to the country night on Saturday?
I think it was like Dwight Yoakam and Jake Owen and Rocket Club, I think. Yeah, so man, what a fun night. What a good time. So get on out. Let's have a good time. Then you got Twin Cities Summer Jam coming right up as well. It's all happening, Corey. Hey, speaking
ladies
of
and gentlemen,
go
can
ahead.
I please
you
have
button,
your attention?
Please.
I've just been handed an urgent and horrifying news story.
You guys like free tickets and stuff?
Man,
always.
So much.
Well, it sounds like I think we're giving away free tickets all week long and starting now because Three Doors Down coming to Treasure Island Resort and Casino on November 4th. Yeah, you love
Friday,
tonight.
Baby.
Friday, November 4th. Three Doors Down, Treasure Island Resort and Casino.
I just played that earlier this morning and didn't
you
know
did.
This was happening.
I thought that I was like, I thought you were maybe foreshadowing, but you weren't, huh?
No,
he was not.
Well, can we do that right now? I mean, how do I do this? It's been a long time since I had anything to give away.
Caller 11 wins a pair. Oh, gosh, Train. I love this song.
It's a great song.
Mm-hmm. Hold on.
You can finish your sentence and then hum afterwards if you like.
I just love this.
I know you do. It's okay. You probably have it on your phone if you'd like to listen to it later.
Caller 11. Caller 11 wins a pair of tickets to see Three Doors Down in concert at Treasure Island Resort and Casino. You can get your tickets at ticasino.com. The public on sale, according to this, looks like it's tomorrow.
Wow, that's awesome. Yeah. So is that at the outdoor amphitheater? Did you just say that?
No,
is
it's November.
No. Okay, it's November. I'm sorry. I wasn't listening very well.
It'd be chilly.
It would be very, very cold.
That's weird, Zach, because in Vegas this weekend at Excalibur, Three Doors Down from you was a murder.
Oh, man.
Yeah, but you know what? He had front row tickets, and he was very happy. And he was eating a Blizzard, and he was high as a kite.
Mm-hmm. And I was here without you. That doesn't work.
You were on a train, too. Go ahead and say it if you want.
Friday, November 4th. More information at ticasino.com.
Oh, that's awesome, man. Good, good, good.
Not my time.
Wow. Why go to the show in November?
Man, I had no idea that
you were going to listen to the Power Trip Morning Show and have Zach sing the song.
I will start a Three Doors Down cover, man.
No, you will not. I bet.
I would also bet that you're not going to do that.
But you don't do that.
But how would that sound?
You want me to sing?
Sure, please. Brad Arnold's here with us now.
Hi, Brad.
No, you are.
Oh,
you don't.
Hi, I'm Brad. what song you want me to do?
Your best.
Hi, Brad. Please.
I'm here without you, baby.
Yeah, you just been fired from your own band.
Hey, Zach, what would the name? I feel like because you're sitting in Sauce's chair, I'm forcing you to do improv. What would the name of your Three Doors Down cover band be?
69 Doors Down.
Well, you really like that. Terrible. You like that one a lot, didn't you?
That's a terrible name.
What is this, the MGM Grand? How big is this hotel?
Yeah.
Jesus.
That's a terrible name.
Yeah.
What else?
What other names?
Yeah.
Four Scores Down.
Oh, thank God.
What?
I don't know of many rock bands from Mississippi. Do you know Three Doors Down was from Mississippi?
I do, Biloxi.
Okay, nobody cares.
Man, maybe you are further along in this cover band adventure than we thought, because you have a lot of information on Three Doors Down.
Yeah. He wrote the Kryptonite in his high school classroom.
Yeah.
He was like 14.
They were like, get out of here. You've been in, you graduated 20 years ago.
Yeah. Yeah. We're straight up. Right, you're supposed to be 100 yards away from the school.
Sir, please.
Get out of here.
We've told you a million times. You're not allowed back in here. But I'm writing a song about Superman. That's been done. Get out of here. Right, here we go.
It's time for Fan 5, brought to you by Builders and Remodelers.
Hey, thanks, Builders and Remodelers.
Yeah, thank you. I'm going to apparently take caller number 11 at 1-800-320-5326.
Oh, yeah.
The Twins won 6-3 over Chicago. That was in Chicago. Buxton hit home run number 22. Arise was 3-for-5. He's batting .348. The Twins scored 4 in the top of the 10th. The White Sox got 1 in the bottom, but of course the Twins hold on to win. They are 46-37. Chicago is 38-40. Twins have won 3 of their last 4. They're at Chicago tonight and tomorrow. Then they're at Texas after that. And also, they had the first 8-5 triple play in Major League Baseball history. Just terrible, terrible base running by Chicago, but Buxton caught it. Urshela got the tag, stepped on second base, triple play, 8-5. First time ever, Michael J. Musman the III.
That's crazy. Honestly, that sounds like something that would happen to the Twins.
Right.
Not that the Twins would actually pull it off.
Yeah, I don't know. I'm sure somebody asked those two guys what were they thinking or what were they doing, but right. You watch the play and you go, where were you running? Why didn't you tag? Did you think he dropped the ball?
Right.
I mean, he clearly caught it. I don't understand why they never stopped.
What's the base coach doing?
Well, that's right. The big thing, because obviously if it's, you know, in right center field, they're looking to their left. They're looking the complete opposite way. And I would imagine, yeah, the base coach or somebody's supposed to be like, hey.
Yeah.
But the weird thing, again, the guy that's on second, the guy that was pitch running, the guy that's on second runs a little bit, then goes back towards second base, right. Almost as if I'm going to tag up. So he's watching Buxton,
yeah. But
he never tags. Buxton catches it. He must have thought he dropped it, because then he just starts sprinting for third. It's so weird.
Yeah, that was very odd. It did look like somebody called a ghost man.
Yeah, that was a crucial mistake, but the Twins will take it. They won 6-3.
Congratulations, Tom Delbar, on winning the tickets to see Three Doors Down, opening up 69 Doors Down, which is a tribute band. To Three Doors Down.
Or Fourscore. The Abe Lincoln Band.
That's true, yeah. 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 Leave before the last song.
Oh, no.
It's like a Gallagher concert in there.
Oh, my. Oh, no. Abe.
You just cry out, Abe.
If only you were in the theater.
Yeah, I know.
If only we had a time machine. Abe. Watch out.
Corey?
Just watching Zach do an impression. I wanted to see how long that would go. Joey Chestnut won the Nathan's hot dog eating contest again.
Yep.
What is it, 15 straight years?
And he beat the crap out of a guy too, right?
Yeah, a protester.
Snapped his neck.
Yeah, right. Didn't you meet a guy named Joey Nutchest when you were in Vegas, Zach?
He also gobbled a lot of hot dogs.
Oh my God! That's way too dirty for 8 o'clock, but well played!
It's not safe harbor.
Nope. Is that all you have, Corey?
I'm waiting for Zach to answer the question about Mr. Nutchest.
I got a keychain
and a couple of decks of cards.
Yeah, we saw that. We did see that. Yep.
Yeah.
Yep.
Yeah. I saw that. Rudy Gobert is now a Timberwolf. He got traded for everybody. He's 30 years old. He's a 3-time Defensive Player of the Year.
We have to correct this. A Three Doors Down tickets go on sale a Friday. Not tomorrow.
Ticketmaster says tomorrow.
Yeah, well, apparently, according to Double E, it is Friday.
Oh, I apologize.
It sounds very...
All right, well, then Ticketmaster also has it wrong. They have a countdown clock. It says tomorrow at 10 a.m.
One hour.
Yep, 49 minutes.
Oh, you know what? Here it is. on sale general public 10 a.m. Friday. There's some pre-sale stuff that's in the next.
Oh, I see what you're saying.
Pre-sale stuff tomorrow, public on sale Friday.
We apologize.
I'd like to play that show with them if they need an opener.
For real, though.
You can't. There's already a couple of cover bands opening up.
Yeah, I heard about one of them.
Yep.
69 doors down.
Yeah, and then four square down.
Yep.
Yep. Did you see Corey Provis from the Twins broadcast? Grew up in Highland Park, Illinois. He said he went to that parade every year.
Yeah.
The one that had the mass shooting over the weekend.
I did see that.
Technically yesterday.
Goodness sakes. Yep.
Isn't that crazy?
Yep. Terrible. Sheesh. Yep. Man.
Some of the photos, not to bring down the room again, but
no, it's just terrifying.
The one gal that has blood all over her face. There's that one photo of the grandfather, looks like dead in the street.
Yeah, jeez Louise, man. Oof. Yeah.
Just the worst.
Hey, back to less tragic stuff. The top 10 best-selling jerseys of 2022.
I have it
right here.
To something.
Of 2022. Okay.
So there's only one I can think of that has to be in the top three or four. Just because you got to think new player, new team,
right?
Big enough name. I got to think Russell Wilson's in the top three or four going to Denver and saying, let's ride, weirdly, a thousand times.
Right. He is number one.
He's number one.
Number one. Wow. That is correct. Yeah.
Oh, Lieber will love that.
Yeah. Yep. I'm sure he does. I'm sure that he does.
I don't think there's a lot of weed out there.
I wonder how many Deshaun Watson jerseys sold.
Ooh. Yikes. Not in the top 10.
I would say, I hope it's not in the top 10.
Right.
That would be embarrassing. Think if you have one.
Yep.
What kind of person would buy a Deshaun Watson jersey after this? I have a lot of questions for those people as well.
He's definitely not going to play this year, right?
I don't know.
I don't know.
You never know.
I'm hearing six games is what I
never know.
That's what I read.
Well,
they said they don't want to
care of it all.
They don't want to go through the appeal process is what I was reading.
Oh, is that right?
So the PA is going to defend him and
I
got you.
Yep. Do you guys want to do any more guessing? Or you just want me to tell you top 10?
Is Patrick Mahomes in there?
Patrick Mahomes is number 9. That is
JJ?
Correct.
He's got to be on there, right?
He is not in the top 10.
What about Devontae Adams with the Raiders?
Number 3. That's right. Devontae Adams, the new Raiders jersey for him. Number 3, right?
Who else has changed teams?
Von Miller?
Von is not on there. Right? Not in the top 10.
Certainly wouldn't be Cook because he just changed his number.
Yep, not yet. Nope. Nope, no Vikings in the top 10.
Tom Brady still in there?
Tom Brady's number 5. That is correct.
Give us the hint at position.
All right, number 2 is a quarterback.
Please don't be
Aaron Rodgers. Right.
It is not.
Oh, thank
Lamar Jack?
Nope.
Joe Burrow.
He's number 10.
Is it the Bills quarterback?
Yeah, Josh Allen. Josh Allen, that's right. Number 4 is a Pittsburgh Steeler.
What?
Nope. Kenny Pickett.
Oh, yeah, I was going to say.
Yeah, Kenny Pickett, number 4. How about that? I know. Oh, he goes, I'll give it to you. Russell Wilson, number 1. Josh Allen, number 2. Devontae Adams, number 3. Then Kenny Pickett at number 4. Tom Brady at number 5. These are, again, your top 10 best-selling jerseys of 2022 so far. Mac Jones comes in at number 6. Cooper Kupp at number 7. Justin Herbert at number 8. Patrick Mahomes at number 9. And Joe Burrow at number 10. Corey, if you were going to be given an autographed jersey of any one of those players, who would you choose?
Brady, and then I would sell it immediately.
Okay.
Yeah. I mean, I'm not keeping it or framing it. I'm going to flip it. Right. So I would either say Mahomes or Brady, but how do you not go with the GOAT and just try to financially benefit? I'd say Brady.
Yeah, you're probably right. That's the way to go. You're right. You're right. I'd get the Russell Wilson one, and I would demand that Ben hang it up and
I would buy it and then give it to Ben.
Yeah, I would just, it would haunt him. Everywhere he went, it would be hanging there. here's a band called 69 Doors Down doing an acoustic cover of Kryptonite.
Brad, would you like to sing?
Sure. Now y'all gotta sing it with me.
Anytime.
Well, when does it start?
Whenever you start, you're the lead singer.
All right.
You're in charge.
Here we go. I took a walk around the world to ease my troubled mind. I left my body lying somewhere in the sands of time. I watched the world flow to the dark side of the moon.
And you're like,
Shut up. I feel there's nothing I can do.
Hang on a second.
When he sings, it's like he's...
That wasn't bad. I gotta be...
Ladies and gentlemen, could I please have your attention?
I'd love it. Please.
Treasure Island Resort and Casino just canceled the show for November.
Oh, no.
Everybody that was interested in the show before has now completely lost interest. Way to go, Zach.
Sands of Time, and there were a couple of words in there that I thought were brilliant. Sands of Time.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, he's a Thrones fan.
Yeah, right. Yeah. And another one I can't remember now. I've lost it.
I thought it was great.
Well done.
Way to go, Zach.
You got one fan. You sold one
Thank
ticket.
You.
Yeah, nice job. Yeah.
Thank you. Front row.
Here, I'll turn my light on my phone here.
Pretty good. Headlines is next. This is the Power Trip Morning Show on the Fan.
Download it now.
8:22. Tuesday, July 5th. If nothing else, it's already Tuesday.
Duh.
The show has flown by.
It's flown by.
Has it gone fast for you, Corey? Because usually when I have a show on the day I'm going to Vegas, everything just slows to a halt.
At points, it does seem like that. And other points, Zach, it seems like this has grinded to a halt.
Yeah.
Okay.
Yeah.
So I think it's been both.
A little roller coaster action.
It's life. Yeah,
it's life. Yeah. You're already on vacation.
Now it's time for headlines.
Headlines, let's go.
Let's do this.
Script for Cora.
Today's National Bikini Day.
Oh, yay! Oh, yeah. That's for sure. That is for sure, buddy.
Celebrate.
Oh, yeah. I'm going to triangle it today.
I don't even know what that means.
Well, yeah, just a bikini. Just a triangle.
Just a triangle.
Yeah.
Interesting.
Yeah.
Cool. Yeah, no, I'd like to see that. You'd work on your tan lines.
Yeah. Come on out to Prior Lake.
I will.
Oh, let's go on the boat.
Okay.
You want to?
Hell yeah, I do.
Yeah.
We can drink?
Yeah.
All right, done.
Yeah.
Let's see that.
A man from Tennessee was arrested at a gas station last Thursday for driving a stolen car. It made the news because he has a Ricky Bobby face tattoo.
Face tattoo.
That's amazing.
I wonder where it's at on his body.
Is it the words Ricky Bobby, or is it the actual picture of Ricky Bobby's face? My guess is it's his face on his face.
Oh, so it was on his face.
Yeah.
Interesting. Yep.
Okay. He's got the number one. Shake and bake.
Maybe.
Probably. Seeing a guy, it looks like he has the words Ricky Bobby in very aggressive cursive over his eyebrow.
Oh, man. Wait, that's not as fun. I wanted it to be a Ricky Bobby face tattoo on his face. Right, a face on a face.
He's got Ricky Bobby and then Ricky and then a money sign in between the eyebrows and then Bobby.
Okay.
That just is not a good idea. I can't imagine not regretting that.
All right,
that's a mugshot that we're looking at right there, right?
Yeah.
I have a lot of questions about this one, but again, that's not how this bit works. This is just headlines. We don't have a lot of details.
Okay.
A guy in Virginia hit the lottery for $250,000 using numbers that came to him in a dream.
Ooh.
The numbers were 13, 14, 15, 16, 17, and 18. Here's what's crazy.
Yeah.
He would have won $1 million if he had gotten the bonus ball right as well. He got it wrong.
What was it? Please tell me.
19.
I knew it.
Oh, my God.
That's impossible. Yeah. That seems impossible.
To the bit there. Yeah.
13, 14, 15, 16, 17, 18. And he didn't guess 19.
That seems impossible.
So the bonus ball must have been different in his dream.
I thought it was a common bit going there for a little while. 13, 14, yeah.
But also, if you only get $250,000 for getting 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 numbers right, I mean, this is not a Powerball situation where the numbers go to 70 or whatever, right?
Right.
In this Virginia lottery here, how high do the numbers go?
I believe it's 69.
And how many different numbers? I mean, that's 7, right, with the big ball?
That's what I'm saying. And you're not winning that much, right?
It's tougher than the Powerball. They've got to be 1 through 20, right?
That's what I'm saying. It must be a much smaller window.
Yeah.
Because otherwise you would get a lot more than $250,000 or a lot more than $1 million if you hit all of them.
Yeah, he's a dreamer. 13, 14, 15, 16, 17, 18.
Zach, why don't you look that up while I'm going on with other things? See if you can figure out the window of opportunity for the range of numbers in this Virginia lottery that this guy hit.
Yeah. There's just no chance he's going to be able to do that.
Well, we'll see. A 90-year-old woman in England who has dementia was starting to need constant care, and her family did not know how they were going to pay for it. Until somebody realized that a painting above her bed was worth a fortune. It's called The Depiction of the Madonna and Child, and it's from the 15th century, and sold at auction for more than $300,000.
It was just hanging above her bed?
How do you have a painting like that, and have no idea that it's worth something?
Wow.
Isn't that crazy?
Yeah, that is crazy. Like Antiques Roadshow kind of stuff, you know?
Yeah. Like, $300,000, just hanging there?
Yeah.
So now they're going to use that for part of her care.
This has been above the Esser in my grandpa's house for 30 years.
We aim to please, you aim to please. And it is right next to that one.
That's
clever. Yeah.
That's clever.
Zach, do you have the answer?
I do. It's 1 through 40, Corey.
Jeez, that's still crazy, though.
But the way how that works is you decide how much you wager to win the prize you want to win.
Oh. Mm-hmm.
So the total play must add up to $2, but you can do two plays at $1 each. You have which gives you a chance to each win $500,000, or you can do four different sets of numbers for 50 cents each, which gives you a chance to win $250,000.
I just flunked math in 12th grade because of your...
I caught zero logic and all that.
My
and
math
that last
grade.
Bit.
I'm so much more confused.
So what you're saying is he did the 50 cent option. So
yeah.
The numbers came to him in a dream, but he still had three other guesses.
Right.
Yeah, he wasn't totally confident in his dream.
I wonder why. James Cameron wants all of us to stop bitching about long movies.
Yeah, stop bitching, people.
He says, quote, I don't want anybody whining about the length when they sit and binge watch 8 hours of TV. It's like, give me an effing break.
Yeah, give him a break.
I've watched my kids sit and do 5 1-hour episodes in a row. He adds, quote, here's the big social paradigm shift that has to happen. It's okay to get up and go pee. Chris, you go to the bathroom about 6 times per film.
I have to. All the movies are too long.
I can't go to a movie theater because of it.
See, but I'm kind of with James on the whole. Yeah, if it's a good movie and it's 3 hours, go and put up with it, right?
Yeah.
I didn't pee once during Jurassic World. I wish I would have just got up and left.
Yeah, I feel you.
Not gotten up and peed, but I'm not a guy that pees at movies. I would rather basically have full-on kidney failure.
Right. I almost died at Gone Girl. Last hour of it.
Yeah.
Almost died at Gone Girl.
Yeah, when you got to pee so bad, you're sweating.
Yeah.
That's when you know.
Yeah. I was making like seal sounds when I finally got to get to the bathroom. Just
seal sounds?
You were standing there going, but I'm never going to survive.
Bret Michaels hit the stage again Saturday night after being hospitalized due to a bad reaction to medication last week. So,
yeah.
Sigh of relief for Carly.
Yeah, for sure. Yeah, I'm glad he's...
He's got a lot of health issues, though.
I mean, he sure has.
Him to actually still go up and do it up on stage?
Yeah.
Good for him.
You know, he's on a stadium tour right now.
Yeah.
Which is just bizarre to me, because
stadium tour?
Yeah, he played... Yeah,
they're playing with Joan Jett, Motley Crue, and Def Leppard.
Oh, I was going to say, there had to be... Yeah.
Right, there's other... Yeah. But still, like, he gets to go in these big stadiums. They're playing Target Field, I think, this summer as well. And it's just weird, because you saw him a couple years ago at... the Vikings deal.
Yeah, the kickoff party.
So he goes from playing that park or whatever for free, basically, to then playing the, 50,000 people. What a weird career.
By the way, it's U.S. Bank Stadium,
sir. Oh, it is?
Sir.
Okay, I apologize.
Sunday, August 14th, Motley Crue, Def Leppard, Poison, and Joan Jett at U.S. Bank Stadium.
Really?
Sunday, August 14th.
See, if you told me Bret Michaels was on a stadium tour, I would just say he's probably really into architecture.
Oh.
After being canceled by CBS, Magnum PI is moving to NBC.
Oh, there you go. It ain't over yet.
I mean, if you're NBC.
Yeah. Go ahead.
And CBS goes, what are we doing? We're done with Magnum PI.
Yeah, right.
If you're NBC, isn't this admitting we are completely out of ideas?
Selleck's not a part of this, right?
No.
No, no. No Higgy Baby? Nothing?
Speaking of shows that went the wrong way, The Time Traveler's Wife on HBO.
Yeah.
The season premiere got around 300,000 viewers, which is not great. The finale got 200,000. It's been canceled after one season.
Yeah, well, you know, nobody liked her.
We talked about it earlier, but Minions: The Rise of Gru set a record for the biggest July 4th opening weekend.
Nobody saw it, right?
No.
Nope. I know. Except
my son saw it. He didn't think it was that great.
I will go see it. I want to see Elvis as well, but I still haven't seen Top Gun.
Ooh, I want to see
a lot of stuff. I want to see
Top Gun. Is really a good. It's absolutely like the old experience of going to a movie.
Yeah.
I mean, it has that same kind of feel to it.
Yeah.
Which I did enjoy that.
Agreed.
I wouldn't say it's not like an Oscar movie, but it's good. It's entertaining.
I'm looking forward to it.
Clint Eastwood won $2 million from a CBD company that was using his name and likeness to advertise.
Hmm.
I don't understand why that company thought you got to do that.
Yeah.
Right?
I don't
And what was the angle that they were going with Clint Eastwood? I mean, was it get off my yard?
I don't know, but I mean, if you call, I don't know exactly what they called it, but if you call it Clint Eastwood and have his name and face on it, if you have any success, you're going to get sued.
That's how good their weed is.
Yeah.
Because they thought that was a good idea.
Do you feel lunky punk?
Yep.
Get off my grass.
Yeah. They sat there all squinty hiding like, you know what we should do.
This guy's strategy was interesting. A 44-year-old guy in Florida.
I know that guy.
Is facing charges after he tried to land a security job at Disney World by trying to expose their weaknesses in security protocols. He tried to steal an R2-D2 just to show that he could, and that's why they needed to hire him.
Ooh.
Because he noticed it was stealable.
That's kind of clever.
That's really clever. Yeah, you go to a liquor store, do the same thing.
It didn't work. He dressed up as an employee, walked into one of their resort hotels on May 31st, and then tried to steal a replica R2-D2 droid worth $10,000. This story says, if anything, it showed that their security is fairly robust because they caught him almost immediately because someone saw him pushing a cart around and it seemed suspicious, so security confronted him. He claimed to work there. They knew he was lying, and he was arrested.
That's brilliant. Top notch, guys. You're doing a great job.
Great job. Never
you
mind.
Caught me.
Never mind.
But how great is it that if his argument right there on the spot would be, look, I'm just trying to show you how bad your security is.
Right.
They'd say, well, we caught you, so not only are you not hired, you are arrested, and your analysis of our security was completely wrong.
No, I'm undercover boss, and that's what I was doing this whole time.
He tried to lead them to an employee locker room, but went the wrong way. Then he couldn't open the locker that he claimed was his. When they asked for his boss's name, he gave the name of an employee who works in California, not Florida.
Hi, I'm Robert Osborne.
I love that he didn't, like, break the fourth wall. You know, I mean, he stayed with it the whole time.
Right. Keep going.
Yeah.
Oh, yeah?
Committed to the bit.
Why don't I just take you to my locker?
I love that they knew he was lying and just went along with it. Like, yeah, okay.
Yep.
Take us to the locker, man.
What's your boss's name? A great bit.
Yeah.
Did zero research.
Not work at all.
They do that in like the software world.
Like hackers.
Hackers and stuff. They pay people to try to.
Yeah, it's like Frank Abagnale Jr. Right. from Catch Me If You Can. Is if you can't, you know, beat him, have him join you.
Yeah, for sure.
Yeah.
My neighbors, one of my neighbors, Steve, has met Frank Abagnale, the real one.
Really?
Yeah.
How?
Hi.
One final segment of the Power Trip Morning Show after this on The Fan.
Redeemed a $50,000 cash prize playing Chumba Casino online.
I was only playing for fun, so winning was a dream come true.
Chumba Casino is America's favorite free online social casino. You too could have the chance to win life-changing cash prizes. Absolutely anybody could be like Mary. Be like Mary. Log on to ChumboCasino.com and play for free now. No purchase necessary. Void where prohibited by law. 18 plus terms and conditions apply. See website for details. The voice in the preceding commercial was not the actual voice of the winner.
Segment for our Tuesday, July 5th edition of the Power Trip Morning Show. It's going to be hot everywhere out there.
A dangerous heat wave will roast millions of Americans across the plains and the Midwest this week. Trey Thomas with more.
The National Weather Service reports 30 million people from South Dakota, Iowa, and Illinois, south into Texas, Louisiana, and Mississippi are under heat advisories. Parts of the central and southern plains, the mid-Mississippi Valley, and the mid-south will see highs in the upper 90s to low triple digits. High humidity will jack up the heat index to a dangerous 105 to 110 degrees in the mid to late afternoon.
Oh.
Bring it. It's kind of ominous when he's like, it's going to roast millions.
A bunch of people out there.
I love this heat. Bring it on.
You do?
Oh, yeah.
90 today, 79 with scattered thunderstorms tomorrow.
You're so...
No, just bring it on. I mean,
why?
If everyone's sweaty, then it's not a bad thing.
You should have seen me last night.
Oh, did you just have some duck butter going?
Oh, terrible.
Yeah.
Yeah, today could be, I should say tomorrow could be the only day under 80 for a high we see for the next 2 weeks.
Oh, dude, this beat's being cold, man.
Nope, disagree. I like the cold, but whatever, you know what?
Bring
I'm happy
on.
For you that you're happy.
Yeah.
Either way, just stay in your basement.
Yeah, you're going to be hot there, Core. I bet it's going to be warm in Vegas, I'm guessing.
Yeah, but I'm going to be outside for a total of about 3 minutes.
Touche, touche.
Yeah, how did they do that before air conditioning?
Oh, I can't imagine. Can you imagine? I can't imagine.
Vegas
yeah.
before air. Oh, that's a good question.
I can't imagine.
There's only so many fans with ice cubes that you can put out, right?
Yeah, you watch a lot of cartoons.
You sure do, buddy. But I do think that's how they used to do it. I think he's right. I don't know about the fan part, but I think people used to lay their privates across the ice to cool themselves off.
Their privates.
I believe that's true. I believe that's true. That's what I would do. Hey, check this out. This is pretty cool. Rihanna.
Just leaving divots in the ice.
Yeah, right. Rihanna.
Mm-hmm.
She's rich.
Rihanna is the nation's youngest self-made female billionaire. The 34-year-old singer recently topped Forbes' annual list of America's wealthiest self-made women for the third straight year. The 9-time Grammy winner's estimated worth of $1.4 billion makes her the only female billionaire on the list under the age of 40. Forbes noted Rihanna amassed most of her fortune from her own music and beauty ventures.
Thanks, Dan Cook. So my question, hang on a second, though. There's no way she's written most of her music, right?
I really don't know.
I don't think she has. So how does she have that much money?
Must be the beauty products, I guess, and probably good investments.
Well, if she has a writing credit on a song. Right. That counts.
Maybe.
Well, the Fenty beauty thing, it's the biggest thing for women right now, like with the makeup and everything. It's huge. I mean, Rihanna hasn't put out an album almost 10 years, I think. And
wow,
she's still.
Really?
Yeah, it's been a long, long time. It's kind of like a running joke amongst her fans that she's just never going to make a song again, like never going to make an album again. But yeah, it's all from the Fenty
beauty.
All right,
so between Rihanna and her makeup and like Kylie Jenner and her makeup, why don't we just do that? I want to be a billionaire. Why don't we just start our own makeup line?
We could.
Yeah, okay. I'm going to test it on animals, though. Because I like pretty animals, man. I hate dogs that are ugly.
Yeah, they always say you can't put lipstick on a pig, and I disagree.
Yeah.
Makes them way sexier. Haven't you seen the Muppets?
By the way, I didn't know that Fenty was her last name.
Oh, yeah.
That's why it's called Fenty. I did not.
Makeup, and they do lingerie and stuff like that.
And cups at Starbucks.
She owns 50% of Fenty, which is worth a lot of money. Then she owns a stake in a lingerie company called Savage X Fenty, which is worth an estimated $270 million. And then chart-topping music actress as well.
I changed my mind. That's what I'm going to do. I'm going to invest in lingerie, makeup, and I'm going to be a chart-topping celebrity.
Okay.
And I'm going to have $1.4 billion.
Are you going to do that when you get back from Vegas, or are you going to do that today?
Simultaneously.
Oh, wow.
I'm
going to
be planning my lingerie line and my makeup line while I'm on the flight.
We're probably not
going to
play.
So Puma has lingerie?
Oh, no. They're going to have to pay to be a part of it.
Yeah, of course. Pumi. Here's an interesting fact about Denzel Washington.
Denzel Washington set to be the only entertainer to receive a Presidential Medal of Freedom this year. The medal honors public figures who've made notable contributions to American society, culture, politics, or world peace. Others who made the cut, Simone Biles and Megan Rapinoe.
Thanks, Dane Cook. So that's pretty cool for Denzel.
Yeah, man.
Do you want one of those?
A Presidential Medal of Freedom?
Yeah.
I'd rather have $1.4
billion. Ooh.
Not even close.
Yeah, I would agree with you on that.
You know?
Yeah.
Why? You want the other one?
I like either. Yeah, I think you could shoehorn.
But you can only have one.
Yeah, if you're going to choose
$1.4 billion or a Presidential Medal of Freedom.
I can profit off the Medal of Freedom somehow.
Not to $1.4 billion?
Like you put that on the cover of your book.
Nope. Ain't going to sell a lot.
You're gonna write a book?
Yeah.
About what?
My life story, a little memoir.
Malat's story.
Well, that's the title.
Malat's story. The story of a young man who can't speak.
That's going to be the first audiobook with subtitles.
Martin Cooper invented the cell phone, and he says, get off the damn things.
What would you say to anybody like myself who are upwards of 5 hours?
Do you really? You really spend 5 hours a day? I would say, Jane, get a life.
He's 92 years old now. 50 years ago, he invented the world's first cell phone. It was 1973. The phone was called the Motorola Dynatac 8000X.
Yep.
Obviously, it looks nothing like the smartphones we have now. A phone was basically a 13-inch brick of plastic with an antenna sticking out of the top.
First two cell phones ever went to Gordon Gekko and Zach Morris.
That's exactly right.
Nailed it.
Yeah, so he was on BBC talking about it, and he said, hey, what are you doing?
Did you ever get that weekly screen report?
Oh, yeah.
And you immediately call BS? Because it's weird. I'll have a week where, I haven't really been on my phone that much. And then the little weekly screen report will be up and be like, you spend an average of 4 hours and 15 minutes a day. I'm like, I do? What am I doing with my life? And then I'm going to cut back. And then the next week I've lowered it by 3 minutes a day. Right? What?
Mission accomplished.
It always feels like it's like shaming me in a way. Yeah. I was just like, but you need to be on more. Like, that's what mine's always like pretty low. And then they'll be like, you should probably be on this more.
I like when it sends me my weekly screen time average at 3 o'clock in the morning on a Saturday morning. And I'm going, are you kidding me? This is the time to tell me how often I'm on my phone. Let me sleep. Stupid ass alarm clock.
We finally heard from Travis Barker since his hospitalization from pancreatitis. Turns out it all stemmed from an endoscopy, not a colonoscopy, as previously reported. Travis went in for an endoscopy last Monday, but that night after dinner, he started having excruciating pain. He said during the endoscopy, I had a very small polyp removed right in the very sensitive area, usually handled by specialists, which unfortunately damaged a critical pancreatic drainage tube. It was a life-threatening pancreatitis. He's very grateful that he made it through. So there you go, in case you're wondering.
All right, so it looks like he's on the up and up, though.
It does look like he's going to be.
The scary part is when he says, usually by a specialist.
I know.
So you go bargain basement on that thing?
Yeah, while you're in there, go ahead and take care of that.
Yeah.
Yeah, he was treated by a young boy named Malat.
Yep, that's right. Yeah, he can't speak well. Gucci is selling some cool things you might want to spend your money on, Zach, since you don't save it. Mm-hmm. Gucci unveiled the most expensive thing on their list is a couch bed for cats and very small dogs at $7,500. They also have a poop bag holster that's $460.
Man, am I tired of that. I'm so tired of picking up dog poop, and I've had those puppies for like 2 months. Yeah. It just sucks.
It never stops either, because matter what you do, they keep pooping.
Oh, man.
Oh, they do. They poop a lot. You know what I love is taking the dogs to the dog park, and then the dogs wait until one of them has already pooped, and I picked it up, and then the other one pooped, and I don't have another bag. Here's something else I love. When I accidentally rip the bag getting out of the car and don't know it, and then I put my hand right through it. And
I've done that exactly once. It's the worst.
Yeah. And there's not there's not enough wet wipes in the world to get that poop from under that fingernail. Oh, there's just not.
Man.
There's just not.
Ew.
Yeah. There's going to be poop under my fingernail now for the next 20 minutes, at least. Till I chew them down to nubs.
Oh,
you know, it's weird. If you're prompt, if you get after it right after the dog does his or her thing.
Yeah.
Isn't it weird that the warmth of it makes it feel every time it feels like there's no bag in between.
Yeah. It's the worst.
Every time I have to question whether or not the bag ripped because it feels like you're touching it directly.
It's just the worst. Here's something that I've done a couple of times. I'm pretty sure I picked up other people's dog's poop trying to find my dog's poop because I know the general vicinity and I'm not running over and, you know, catching it as it falls out. And then you walk over and you pick it up and like, well, either my dog's got a real serious health issue and they're pooping cold poop, or I just picked up somebody else's dog poop. Please pick up your own dog poop.
Oh, man.
Dog poop people, whatever.
I can't do it. I got a gag reflex that's just awful.
So you just let them go and leave it?
No. I make my wife pick it up.
Yeah, that's a good idea.
Yeah.
Sometimes I have to fake pick it up if someone's watching and I don't want to. I'll take the bag out and I'll just pretend it.
Well done. You're part of the problem.
They probably are wondering why I'm putting the bag in my pocket a couple steps later. Like, wow, that guy's really weird.
Well done. Gonna save that one for later. We know about Joey Chestnut and the hot dog eating contest. Did you know there was a lemonade chugging contest as well? And we had a champion. His name's Badlands Booker.
Oh, my glory! With a new world record of 1 gallon of Nathan's lemonade. Badlands Booker! Badlands, how do you feel?
Excuse the bad man. Sorry. Woo! Awesome.
What the hell was that?
That was kind of a burp. Kind of a vomit. I'm going to guess he tasted that lemonade.
Mm. That's a huge bitch.
I bet he was.
He's also a rapper.
Is he really?
Yeah, he did like the intro for the on ESPN. He like rapped the intro and he has albums about competitive eating.
Really?
Wow. Yeah. Oh, well. I think they did a story on him last year. I remember like watching it. Yeah.
What other things do they shove in themselves over Nathan's? I mean, it's, come on, how ridiculous is that? Oh, yeah, he's really good at the lemonade. Is it got pulp in it? Oh, no.
No pulp. In it. Not if you can drink it quickly, you know.
Heck.
You can't drink that if it's going to have pulp
in it. Get the pulp out.
Yeah. Once again, and by the way, aren't we playing at Tottenham Hotspur Stadium?
Yeah. That sounds right.
Yeah. Well, the other day, our friend Ande, my good friend Ande, was at the Guns N' Roses concert, and Carrie Underwood came out again. Did anybody see the pictures of this? She's cut from stone.
Okay, but I'm torn on this one, though. I'm torn on this because Carrie's awesome, right? Yeah, but she does nothing for me because I'm just not into country music.
Yeah. But what about her legs?
But if I showed up and it was like Rage Against the Machine, right? And they started playing Killing in the Name and they're like, ladies and gentlemen, Reba McEntire. I'd say,
that would be awesome.
I'm here for Rage. Like, I doubt Guns N' Roses fans are going, oh, great, Carrie Underwood singing Sweet Child of Mine, exactly how I have imagined this forever. Get off the stage. I'm not here for Carrie.
Man, I would watch her.
Oh, man.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Do about anything.
And she is just, she loves that 90s hair band stuff. And she can just, I mean, those pipes. Do you man, like, she can just wail.
Do you like Reba?
Yes.
Okay, then picture this.
Fancy. Fancy. Oh, fancy.
She sings fancy, right?
Yes, she does.
Okay, thank God. Because then nobody would have gotten that joke, and it wasn't even a good one. Corey,
get
your ass out of here. Get on a plane, not a boat. Get a boat if you want. I don't care. And get your ass out of here and go win some money and be happy.
I'm going to try to go win some money. Sauce will be back tomorrow. You'll be salivating when you see it when he returns tomorrow. Paul meets Sauce Lambert. He'll be back. And then I believe Charge hosting initials on Friday when the jackpot's at $10,500. So the next time I'm hosting initials, it'll be Detroit Lakes a week from Friday. Water Carnival. Mark it on your calendars. Be there on July 15th, Water Carnival. That's a major. So one of the Rubes gets to play as well. AJ comes back. Marnie will be there. Parrish, the whole bit, you guys. But that's a week from Friday.
That's right. And we got a whole bunch of radio to do without him. As Saucy, we hope we'll make it back from San Diego. Corey, have a good trip, brother.
Yeah.
Must thank you.
See you next week.
Yeah, you bet. Bye, buddy. Deals, you messed up bad and how no one